Mr. Hanson, the principal here. I'd like to welcome everyone here for our 2013 Grandparents Day. What an awesome turnout. I gotta think this is the most people I have seen here for Grandparents Day. And you know, we have a great turnout on a not so great day. You know, I'm really hoping these last 3 days were not that wasn't summer or whatever. I heard a couple people mention that in the back. You know, I see a lot of familiar faces out here and some new ones, and it's great to see the new faces and welcome back to all those that have been here before. You know, every year I just realize more and more, especially as my own son comes through the system, how important grandparents are and how important all you folks are just to contribute to the life of those little guys and little girls. And just know we all appreciate it, and we certainly appreciate all the support that we get from you here in our district in so many different ways. So thank you so very much. I just want to make sure everyone gets that message before you take off today. I do have another grandpa here. Mr. Walsh is standing over here, who is a grandparent, and he is our district superintendent. Last year, if you were here, he came and told some old people jokes. He's going to spare us of that this year, he said. But he is going to be hanging around a little bit, and if you get a chance to introduce yourself to him, if you're walking around looking at the projects, make sure you do that. We're very fortunate to have Mr. Walsh. He's a great leader and has really done a lot here for our district, so we thank him for coming up. At this point, I want to just give a round of applause. I want to make sure I do recognize those that helped plan the day. So we have Grandparents Day Committee, and I don't want to forget anyone. So we have Janice Larson, who's a grandma, Jackie Canta, who's a grandma, Dawn Hayes, who is a grandma, Julie Brooke, not a grandma, Melissa Linsmeyer, Linda Lucina, Bobby Phillips, and Laura LeJess. So thanks to all those folks. Let's give them a round of applause. I hope everyone got a chance to get some refreshments in the back. Those are provided by our PTO, so I want to recognize our PTO for the refreshments. We have some ladies that have been helping out with serving back there. I want to recognize Sherry Condon, Joyce Schaefer, Dawn Kufall, Kristen King, Kelly Carlton, and Ashley Larson. So let's give them a round of applause. One other thing I want to note, can I see a show of hands? Did anyone here take the shuttle from the church? Okay, just a few. I noticed all the cars that are way down the road, and that's probably some of you folks. If you come next year, we are running a shuttle. You can park at the Shepherd of the Hill Church. The parking lot's right there. Jump on the school bus, just like when you were kids, and then we'll drop you right off here at the front door, and afterwards you'll be back on the bus to go back. We save a lot of walking. I really want to encourage everyone, I'm sure we'll be doing the same process next year. Don't forget we have the shuttle. Take advantage of that. Okay, it's become a tradition here the last few years to hand out some prizes, and I always enjoy this to get to know some of the folks that are here. We have three different prizes. The first prize goes to the grandparent who traveled the farthest. So, let's see, has anyone traveled more than 200 miles? Or if you traveled more than 200 miles, let's see. Where did you come from? Kansas. I don't know any miles, guys. 850 miles. And Stover. Does anyone here think they can beat 850 miles? I have some hands over here. We have some folks here from South Carolina. They think about 1,250 miles. Let's get them wrong. This is Mike and Sharon Brown. So that's 1,250 miles. Can anyone beat that? Oh? Okay, we have two back here. We have Ryan Byron Brunson here from Louisiana. He's saying 1,450 miles. Let's give him a round. I don't know. Do we have anyone from Key West? I don't know. Oh, well, I don't know. Somebody says maybe they can beat you. Let me hustle down. We have Virginia Livesey here from Houston, Texas. She's not exactly sure how far that is, but let's give her a round of applause. Social studies team, so I think it's pretty close between Texas and Louisiana. I think it may be Louisiana, depending on where we're at. But hey, thanks for all of you. If you travel 10 miles or if you travel 1,500 miles, we appreciate you being here today. The next award is going to go to who has the most grandkids. Sometimes you've had the same winner year after year, but last year we did have a different winner. Let's see, who has more than 15 grandkids? 15. Okay, I have some over here. Let's see. Well, she has 16. Can anyone beat 16? 35 grandkids. I can tell how you feel for her. And 36 great grandkids. This is Cindy's fault. Cindy's fault. Can anyone beat that? Okay, this is another one of my favorites, and some of you will get it and some of you will not, but who is the oldest grandparent that we have with us today, which is always kind of interesting. Do we have anyone in here? Do we have anyone in their 80s there with us? We do have some in their 80s. Do we have anyone older than 83? Yeah. 92. Do we have anyone with us older than 92? I do see a hand up over here, but I think we better at least not put our name on it. Betty Wanda, 92. Thank you. That's with us today. Wow. This is the first. We have a 100-year-old reindeer here. Thank you. Falls, Wisconsin here. Can you with us? Okay, at this time we have some music planned for you. We'll have each of the grades come in, so hopefully everyone will at least see your grandchild with at least one song. Mrs. Linsmeyer is our music teacher here. I'd like to introduce Mrs. Linsmeyer. And then we have Mr. Lundy-Clark. And we have Mr. Turek here, who is a second grade teacher and always a great help. So as the kids work their way in, they're going to sing some songs to work all the grades through. When that's done, Mrs. Linsmeyer will be dismissing you down. You can hold on the back of the purple sheets that you have as a map. And if you don't know where to go, we'll have people standing around directing you to get to the right place. Find your grandchild in that classroom. They'll show you around the school. Look at some of the independent projects that we have out. Look at the doors. All the doors tell a story. And just enjoy the afternoon. At approximately 2:25-ish, we will be doing a goodbye song. We will have to ask people to exit at that time because the buses will be leaving. So thank you all for coming, and I hope you have a wonderful day. And let's look for some more warm weather. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. And so we'll be singing some different verses for you. And they also have another song, Somebody's Knocking at Their Door, that they will be using instruments with.
Yeah.
hard lyrics. They added some sign language to help them learn it. Every second grader, why don't you look and see if you can find a grandma and grandpa out there, wave to them.
We stay away, girl, you're the emblem of love.
Rocky Mountain. We are not using the piano. They are going to accompany themselves. They've been working really hard on these instrument parts for you. Can all my third graders find the grand number and put their wave high? been working really hard on a song called Now Let Me Fly. They are also playing instruments for themselves. We're not using the piano on this. They've been working really hard. It is a two-part song, and they have done excellent on it. Thank you for coming. The fourth graders are going to head out. Please, if you're going to go meet your grandchild, go meet them down in their classrooms. I hope you enjoyed the show, and I hope you enjoyed visiting our school. Thank you.